it live. It better be the match of his life, JR. It may literally be the match of his life. And there you see the title hanging high above the ring. King, there's only one way to get there, and that's by the use of the ladder.
Well, this match was Jeff Hardy's idea, and rightfully so. He's used to these type of matches. This is the first one ever for The Undertaker.
This matchup, there will be no pinfalls. There will be no submissions. There are no disqualifications, nor no countouts. Only one way to win, and that's by climbing the ladder and securing the undisputed championship belt that hangs high above the center of the ring. There is no doubt that Jeff Hardy is extreme. He is very extreme.
He didn't have to be. Oh, wait a minute. Don't be that extreme now, Jeff. Don't make a stupid mistake. What is he doing, JR?
It's obvious to me that Jeff Hardy's trying to get in the Undertaker's head. And I think he has. And, oh, Jeff Hardy! From kicking that ladder right back in the face of the undisputed champion. Jeff Hardy lured the Undertaker to the outside.
Look at
this! Catching the crossbody over the top. And the extreme Jeff Hardy, he's a risk taker, he's a daredevil, and he knows he cannot be disqualified. The Undertaker hit right between the eyes with a solid shot, with a steel chair.
Jeff Hardy's been thinking about this match all week. Obviously, he is ready for this. And just remember, he does not have to pin The Undertaker to become the undisputed champion. Look out.
Jeff Hardy. Outmaneuvering The Undertaker that ladder. Again, Jeff Hardy, a veteran of those historic TLC matches and ladder matches. The Undertaker knocking down Jeff Hardy has never been in a ladder match in his long, successful, illustrious career here in the WWE.
But he's in one now, and it can turn out to be the match of his life.
Jeff Hardy giving up size and strength and power. And that may be too much to overcome in a normal match. But ladies and gentlemen, this ain't no normal match. This is a ladder match. This is a Hardy extreme specialty.
Yeah, but you gotta remember, JR, just think back to last week. The Undertaker literally extremely destroyed Jeff Hardy. I mean, he destroyed him.
And Jeff Hardy, though, had enough guts to issue this challenge. And maybe on that night, Jeff Hardy outsmarted The Undertaker because The Undertaker has never been in this ladder match environment. And that's where we are, and The Undertaker clubbing and hammering away at Jeff Hardy on the outside. Remember, you can't be disqualified. You can't be counted out. You can't, the pinfalls don't count, and there are no submissions.
I know. I realize that. But I think now you're seeing the dominance of The Undertaker start to emerge here. This is probably why The Undertaker, well, quite frankly, it just sounds like he's just looking past Jeff Hardy. He's thinking about Kurt Angle. He's thinking about The Rock. He didn't even mention Jeff Hardy.
The Undertaker, so sadistic. He is an evil executioner, is this man. And he can just beat on Jeff Hardy as long as he wants. Uh-oh. If The Undertaker chooses.
I think he's about to introduce Jeff Hardy up close and personal to that ladder that he likes so much. Here we go. Oh, no, wait. Oh!
The Undertaker, Jeff Hardy came unmounted and drove The Undertaker's face, his chest, his lower torso right into that ladder. They can beat each other all they want, but the match will continue if it takes us all night long until somebody can climb that ladder. Leg dropping the ladder on top of The Undertaker's prone carcass. This match can continue all night until somebody can pull that undisputed title belt.
I sometimes think that Jeff Hardy should have considered a career as a crash test dummy. I mean, he'll absolutely risk life and limb in these matches.
As they say here in New Hampshire, live free or die. And Jeff Hardy's career could die here tonight in this matchup. Or it could be made. It could be history in the making, one way or the other, before this was all said and done. And The Undertaker driving that ladder right up into Jeff Hardy's face.
Oh, man, did you see that?
Undertaker's not been back in this ring since being lured out of the ring, outmaneuvered mentally, if you will, by the extreme Jeff Hardy. And now the Undertaker back in the squared circle.
Jeff writhing in pain here, King, right in front of us.
Well, Undertaker just kicked that metal ladder right into the ribs of Jeff Hardy. It's a miracle. It could have cracked a couple of them. Oh, no, look out there.
Undertaker using
that.
They
could come flying over here.
I told you, Jeff Hardy's face, his prone body, just went limp on our table. And the Undertaker now setting that ladder up.
And his chances, watch this again, look at that. Jeff Hardy's chances of becoming the undisputed champion are going limp right now as well.
Jeff Hardy lying out.
Better get up, boy. Better get up, Jeff.
It's going to be over quickly. It's going to be over.
Better get up.
Undertaker, look, what's he thinking? Undertaker, all he's got to do is climb the ladder and get his undisputed title belt and leave.
He's sadistic. He hadn't inflicted enough punishment pain yet.
But Ben King, you know as well as I do, when you got a chance to win a match and you don't do it,
well,
more often than not, it can come back and bite you right in your butt.
Well, you heard what the Undertaker said. He is determined that he is not going to leave Jeff Hardy standing. Jeff Hardy is not going to be able to walk. Oh, no!
What the hell are you? You're breaking his kid in half. There's no reason for that.
Come on.
Jeff Hardy can't. I don't even get him to defend himself.
Easy, JR. He's not the man to mess with. Don't provoke him.
Oh, I'm not trying to provoke him, but there's another human being being destroyed in front of our very eyes, and some of us give a damn.
Key word there is another human being, JR. Don't stick yourself in there and put yourself at risk. You know you enjoy this.
Jeff Hardy fell right into the timekeeper's table. Wow. This is sad. This is damn sure sad. The Undertaker, that chair, driving right into the sternum of a helpless kid that came here to put his career on the line to become the undisputed champion.
Well, what the hell did you expect, JR? The kid asked for a ladder match with the Undertaker? What did you expect? You think he's going to come out unscathed?
His ass.
Oh, cool. He's going to take the whipping of his life.
Well, he's taking it.
He's not going to walk out of this arena tonight.
Undertaker's still going to come back and bite him in his ass when he didn't win the match when he had the chance.
Undertaker may come back and bite who in their ass? He's kicking ass is what the Undertaker's doing.
Undertaker loves punishing people. He loves hurting people.
Let me make one thing perfectly clear to you, okay? Jeff Hardy asked for this match.
I know.
You heard him last week. You saw him.
Well, what do you mean to do about it?
I want a ladder match.
I heard what he
well,
said.
He's got it now.
And he's being physically dissected by perhaps the most evil and intense human being.
And whose fault is that? Whose fault is that, JR? It's Jeff Hardy's. He asked for it, and he's getting it.
Well, I still have compassion for another human being.
And he deserves
whether he asked for it or not. Well, I don't know if he deserves being dismantled. I don't know if he deserves having his career taken away from him. Does anybody deserve that? Is that what he deserves? He deserves to get his guts beat out of him? Does he deserve to get his ass sent home to North Carolina forever? Does he deserve that? I don't think so. I wish the Undertaker were through. This is getting sick.
Undertaker's not going to be through for a long time. He's going to drag this out. He's going to make this punk kid suffer.
Jeff Hardy trying to fight back, but you got to wonder how much he's got no punches. He's got everything. He's going to answer everything he's got. Everything he's got. Jeff Hardy fighting back. On the right hand. Woo-hoo. Knocking down the challenger.
Woo-hoo. That sent a little message.
What an offensive flurry by Jeff Hardy. And it may have been everything he had left.
Yeah, he was flailing away like. I'll just tell you this. The Undertaker just sent a message to Jeff Hardy, and he's sending a message to everybody right now. Every WWE superstar, but especially Kurt Angle, and especially The Rock. He's showing these two guys what he's capable of.
Well, it may be sending a message. This tonight is not about Kurt Angle, and it's not about The Rock.
Oh, yes, it is.
It's about Jeff Hardy trying to live his dream and making a challenge in a match that he thought he had a better than 50-50 chance of winning.
Did you actually think that Jeff Hardy had a better than 50-50 chance of winning this match?
In the ladder match, I damn sure did.
How wrong are you?
Well, it's not over, is it?
I don't know. Let's see.
And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I've been wrong before. But this is not over.
It'll be over when The Undertaker says it's over. It might be over right here.
Oh, my. You got to be kidding.
You can't do right this. Here.
Don't do that.
Hardy sandwich.
I hurt The Undertaker. Too bad. But Jeff Hardy just got dismantled. He has been completely torn apart. And the referee can't stop it. Because there's no disqualifications, you can't be counted out. There's only one way for this match to end, and that's when someone climbs the ladder and gains possession of the Undisputed Championship belt, which is hanging high above the center of this ring.
I don't think Jeff Hardy's going to do any climbing tonight. We don't have the right boots on for that.
Jeff Hardy's propped up in the corner, and nowhere to go. Just drill right in the chest, driving the air out of this kid.
You remember what The Undertaker said, don't you? Not only is he going to win the match, but he's going to make sure that Jeff Hardy is not able to walk out of this arena tonight.
And what a sick thought that is.
Why?
What a sick thought.
Why?
To cripple somebody. Jeff Hardy's back, his spine smashed into that ladder, and the ladder could give a damn. It could give a damn about the anatomy of this human being.
Yeah.
And The Undertaker gives a damn less. Jeff Hardy avoided contact. He bought himself a little bit of time.
Don't worry, Undertaker's all right. He's okay.
Undertaker right back on the attack. Undertaker tasting that ladder momentarily. And Jeff Hardy went for the corkscrew. My God, Jeff Hardy went for it all to cut The Undertaker right in the face with that corkscrew off the top.
That's all right. You can't win the match that way.
I can only imagine.
You can get all excited about the corkscrews all you want.
I can only imagine the pain this kid's trying to endure here. He could barely hold the ladder. Nice.
He hadn't had to do what he's going to do.
Undertaker off kicking Jeff Hardy's head, almost off his shoulders, his carcass, his body, certainly out of the ring.
We'll take one more look at this last-ditch effort by Jeff Hardy. Yeah, it was impressive.
Yeah, it's over.
And The Undertaker, instead of setting the ladder up and going for the title, wants to come out here and inflict more pain, and he got a low blow, and again, there's no disqualification.
Well, you condone those kind of actions?
It's no disqualification.
Oh, okay.
You're having a parade for The Undertaker. My God, Jeff Hardy leaping off that ladder, over the top, clearing the top rope, landing on The Undertaker. And now can Jeff Hardy beat The Undertaker back in the ring? Can Jeff Hardy set the ladder up? Can Jeff Hardy become the Undisputed Champion?
One more look at this, the springboard! Using the ladder actually is like a diving board. He dove right over on top of The Undertaker.
And again, this, my God, there's,
okay.
Oh my.
The hell is this?
That's a big ladder. That's a bigger ladder than they started with.
I guess, what's that for?
What's that for? Oh, he's gonna go paint his garage.
What?
Look at this. He set this ladder up. The ladder almost touches the championship belt. Jeff Hardy can live his dream.
Undertaker.
Jeff Hardy can make history.
Undertaker.
This could be the biggest upset ever. Jeff Hardy, his body racked with pain, trying to climb the ladder. The Undertaker finally back in the ring with a clubbing blow to the lower back.
Lower back, back of his head, I think. Oh, look at this. He climbed right into position for the last ride.
Jeff Hardy, a step or two away from history.
Did he?
Jeff Hardy is close. He's touching the goal.
Oh, my God.
What a vile shot to the spine by The Undertaker. Jeff Hardy was touching the title. He was touching the Undisputed title. He was inches away. Was Jeff Hardy from making history?
Oh. Undertaker's going to make it really famous.
And The Undertaker said Jeff Hardy was not going to walk out of here. And he may be right, but again, he may be wrong.
Oh, no, I think he's right.
Wait a minute,
my paycheck, he's right. Come on, give it to him.
Jeff Hardy's trying to fight out of this. He's jumping with the chair. And he's getting taken to the head.
Right?
It may be the night
It may be the biggest night.
Get up, Taker, get up. He's still got that damn chair.
Inches away from immortality.
Ooh.
Oh, God.
Ooh.
Not one, but two shots to the spine of this kid. Oh. The Undertaker almost out on his own feet. And now he's climbing the ladder.
Oh.
But Jeff Hardy is close.
Get it. Get your title. You're the Undertaker.
Oh, look out. Come on, kid. You can still do it. One more step.
Oh,
one more step.
He got his hand.
Jeff, oh my God! Oh God, no! No, 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 no! The chokeslam on the top of the ladder! And the Undertaker with a chokeslam on the top of the ladder has won one hell of a fight! One hell of a fight!
Here is your winner, and still the WWE Undisputed Champion, The Undertaker!
This match took a tremendous amount out of The Undertaker, and poor Jeff Hardy gave us everything he had.
Yeah, but Undertaker kept his word. He gave us his word that Jeff Hardy would not walk out of this arena. Look at him, he's down. He's down and he's out. And The Undertaker is still your undisputed champion. He said Jeff Hardy wouldn't be standing, and he's not. What do you got to say about that, JR?
Jeff Hardy had a hell of an effort. I'm proud of Jeff Hardy. I'm proud of what he put his body through to become the best in the business. But it was not to be on this fateful night, on this ladder match.
Wait a minute. Hey, Undertaker. That punk's getting up.
Jeff Hardy is getting back up.
You better stay down, kid.
This kid is going to, he will not die. Jeff Hardy will not die.
No,
he will not stay down.
Don't speak too soon. Lay down.
Leave him alone.
Lay down, boy.
Enough is enough.
Just laid down.
There's no reason for this.
Well, there is a reason.
Damn last ride.
No. You remember, Dale, he said he was going to become a star. He's not trying. He's going to be checking into that wooden wall door pretty soon.
My God, I can't believe The Undertaker wins a match, and he's got to come back and punish this kid a little bit more with that last ride. And maybe that was the message to Kurt Angle for SmackDown Thursday. Maybe it was the message for The Rock and Vengeance. I don't know. All I know is that Jeff Hardy made his family. He made the WWE proud.
Wait a minute.
Hey!
Oh, tell me he's not talking.
You haven't broke me, Taker. You haven't broke me. I'm still standing.
Oh, God.
No, you're not.
Cut the mic
off. From the ropes, I'm standing.
Cut the damn mic off. That's enough. This kid, Jeff, don't do it.
Right, that's enough,
Jeff.
Jeff,
that's enough.
Throw the mic.
You got nothing to prove, kid.
Give us that microphone.
You got nothing to prove. And Jeff Hardy's defenseless here. There's no reason for this. He can't even defend himself. Ever think of The Undertaker going to do this? This kid who gave us his heart, his soul,
look,
he's helpless.
Look,
he's helpless. As I said, he's defenseless. And look at that! There he is, The Undertaker, raising Jeff Hardy's hand. What the hell is up with that?
Is that?
I guarantee you one thing: Jeff Hardy came to play here tonight on Raw, and before a sellout crowd, Jeff Hardy gave us his heart and his soul to become the undisputed champion in this ladder match. But it was not to be against The Undertaker.
I'm amazed that Jeff Hardy survived it. And I think in surviving it, he earned a note of respect for that man from The Undertaker.
Jeff Hardy should have earned all our respect. There's no doubt about that.